Question number 56. Which of the following anion give canary yellow color during the ammonium molybdate test? So students, the correct answer to this question is phosphate ion, which leads to the formation of ammonium phosphomolybdate, which is a canary yellow precipitate. So, the correct answer to question number 56 is option 4. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 57. A compound CONH3O6-3 positive absorbs visible light of 437 nanometer. The color of the complex appeared is. So, students, if you talk about the visible region, it lies somewhere around 400 to 700 nanometers. So, 437 nanometer would somewhere lie around the violet range. So, and if we talk about the complementary colors, we have VBGYOR. So, if the color absorbed lies in the violet region, the color emitted will be in the yellow region. So, students, we have to select option 3 as the correct answer to this question. Let us look at the next question. Question number 58. Which of the following reactions report the correct major product? So, if we talk about the reaction given in option A, so we have anhydrous AlCl3. It is going to extract this Cl- leading to the formation of carbocation. That carbocation will undergo rearrangement leading to the formation of the tertiary butyl carbocation. And that tertiary butyl carbocation will substitute a hydrogen on the benzene ring to give this compound. Let us look at the second option now. We have been given a cyclic halide which is to react with AgNO3. So it is mentioned to us in the question that AgNO3 replaces the Cl- with OH-. This reaction is not going to happen, students. AgNO3 can cause SN1 reaction. It extracts Cl- from substrates. But if we try and extract a Cl- from this case, we'll have the formation of an anti-aromatic species. So this anti-aromatic species will not form. So this reaction will not take place. Let us look at the C option now. In the C option, we have the substrate reacting with zinc dust in presence of heat. So this zinc dust is going to produce radicals in this case, and that radicals will undergo resonance to form benzene. So this reaction is correctly given, students. If you look at the D option now, so we have the substrate reacting with NaI in acetone. So students, we can see that there is a scope of NGP in this case. So whenever there is NGP, there will be two SN2 attacks, and as a result, there will be no net change in configuration. So there will be a retention in configuration, and the incoming nucleophile will attach to the substrate at that side from where the leaving group had left with no change in the stereochemistry. So the reaction given in statement D is also correct. Only the reaction given in option B is incorrect. So we have to select option 2 as the correct answer to this question. Let us look at the next question now. Question number 59. Correct statement among the following are: SF4 is tetrahedral in nature. This is incorrect, students. SF4 is seesaw shaped structure. Let us look at the second statement now. Beryllium resembles aluminium due to diagonal relationship. This statement is correct, students. Let us look at the option 3 now. BeCl2 can exist in polymeric form. This is correct, students. BeCl2 indeed can exist in a polymeric form. Let us look at option 4 now. Oxidation number of iodine in ICl3 is positive. This statement is also correct. Iodine is in a state of +3 in this case. Let us look at statement 5. White phosphorus is polymeric in nature. It is incorrect, students. White phosphorus exists as discrete P4 units. So students, we have to select the correct statement among these, and out of these given statements, statement 2, 3 and 4 are correct, which is correctly given in option 3. Let us look at the last question for this test. Question number 60. How many stereoisomers are possible for MAAB2C2? So if we talk about the different stereoisomers, the bidentate ligand AA can only have a cis form. Now if we talk about the other four positions, we can have B trans B. So the ligand C and C will be cis to each other. we can also have C trans C, and the B ligands will be cis to each other again. We can also have a third case where we'll have B trans C. So the other B and the C structure will be cis to each other. Now if we talk about the optical activity of these structures, the first structure is optically inactive as there will be a plane of symmetry about which the B and B will be symmetric. The same case will be observed in the second structure where we'll have a plane of symmetry passing through the other four species about which this C and this C will be symmetric. So both of these structures are optically inactive. But if we talk about the third structure, this structure is optically active and it will also have its enantiomer. So a total of four stereoisomers are possible for this structure, and we have to mark option 2 as the correct answer to this question. So this is it for today, guys. I hope the solutions were clear to you. Thank you.